didn't feel like a dream this time, though. I felt like it was actually happening.
Those are the worst kind. Same time.
I know.
Let's try and get back to sleep, okay?
He'd protect us both if he was here.
You bet he would. Boy, you really scratched yourself. Sarah? I'm gonna go put something on this. I'll be right back, okay? What you working on?
Nothing.
Who's that woman you keep drawing?
Nobody.
Come see me if you need that changed, okay?
I can go to the nurse, like everybody.
But I'm right down the hall.
I know, Mom, you're always right down the hall.
Oh, somebody's tail is dragging this morning.
Good to see you, too.
Hot date?
In my dreams. Choice of words.
Same one?
Yeah. They're getting worse. Last night she scratched herself. Pretty bad. And she saw this guy in her room, like he was really there. Kids have bad dreams, right? Comes with the territory. But this... Pam, I don't know what to do.
It's very cute. That's very good, Sarah. But the idea of having a fruit up there was to draw what you see.
Well, I see her.
Where?
Everywhere.
Dreams don't just happen, they mean something. I've done a lot of research.
The psychic hotline doesn't exactly count as research.
Go ahead and laugh, but I'm telling you, they're like a door, a way into another reality. Every time we dream, we open that door. The scary part is we don't know what's on the other side.
You're serious?
Take her father, for example. How much does she know about him?
Oh. She knows he was a police officer, and he was killed in the line of duty 3 weeks before she was born, but she doesn't know the details. What does that have to do with anything?
There may be things that she needs to know, and she's not even conscious of it yet. The dreams could be her way of filling in the blanks.
Pam, she's only 10 years old.
She never got to meet him. That's very mysterious for a child. It's only natural she'd have questions.
She just seems so fragile.
Just talk to her, Kim. Tell her about her dad. Something tells me she's a lot stronger than you think.
And this is when your dad made detective. God, he was so excited that day. We both were.
He helped a lot of people.
Yeah, he did.
And dead people.
Well, yeah, if a bad person hurt somebody, he made sure that they didn't hurt anyone else.
I wish I could have known him.
So do I.
Mom, what really happened to Daddy?
Right before you were born, an art student by the name of Penny Romig was killed. Daddy found out that Ben Davies was the one that killed her. So when he went to arrest Davies, he started shooting. Daddy shot back. They both died. Sarah. Honey.
She died.
She was murdered.
Can I sleep with you tonight?
Sure, baby. You want to talk about it? Sarah, I can't help you if you don't tell me.
You'll get mad.
I won't.
Promise?
I promise.
Sometimes I see stuff in my dreams.
What kind of stuff?
Stuff that never happened to me. It's like someone's in my head.
Like voices?
Yeah. Like they're remembering things for me. From someone else's life.
Sarah, you can't remember somebody else's life. You just can't. It's they're just dreams, baby.
I'm tired.
Sure, baby. Go on up.
Mrs. Shea? Why don't you wait here while I talk to your mom?
I'll be right back, sweetie.
Sarah seems a bright little girl. Very mature for her age. But she's clearly very tormented by what she sees in her nightmares.
Dr. Warner, what's wrong with my little girl?
I believe her wounds are an expression of deep inner conflict. Now, what that may be, I don't know yet. Has Sarah experienced any emotional or physical trauma in the last few months?
No, just these dreams.
These are more than dreams, Mrs. Shea. This man she keeps seeing is very real to her and very scary. She believes this hallucination really exists.
Hallucination?
Whatever is disturbing her is affecting her conscious world.
But what can I do?
If she continues to cut herself, she may require medication, even hospitalization.
Oh, God.
But first, Mrs. Shea, I want you to talk to your daughter. Listen to what she has to say, however hard it may be.
But I do.
Sarah doesn't think you believe her. That can be very alienating for a child. There's something she hasn't told anyone. Something very important. And you need to find out what that is.
You think I'm crazy?
No, no, I would never think that.
I'm scared, Mama.
Me too, baby. Look, if there's anything you need to tell me, anything at all.
I could show you something.
Show me?
Something that I've seen in my head.
What is it?
I don't know. I have to... so you. Go that way.
You've seen this before? In your head?
Okay, now you've shown me. We... Sorry, we were just...
Just what, huh? What are you hanging around my door for?
Nothing, we were just going.
Can we take a look inside?
No, we are...
Hold on. Maybe that's not such a bad idea.
Get out of our way. Come on, Sarah.
S'il te plaît, je ne veux pas mourir. S'il te plaît, tu me fais mal. Pourquoi tu fais ça, Lara? S'il te plaît, ne vous pas.
Wake up! Hypnosis can sometimes help you to remember what happened. And then we can begin to figure out why you're having these scary dreams, okay?
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You're in a very deep sleep now, Sarah. But when I snap my fingers, you'll wake up. You're surrounded by a protective light. Nothing, no one can hurt you in this light. Do you understand? Now, I want you to go back to when you're 5 years old. You're having a birthday party with all your friends, remember?
Yes.
How are you feeling?
Good. All my friends are here. They love it when I draw them, and I make them look really silly, and they all laugh.
Do you like to draw your friends?
Sometimes I draw other things.
Like what?
From before, when I was big, older.
When you were older?
I was tall and pretty.
You mean grown up?
Shouldn't talk about it, though. My mom gets mad and we argue a lot.
It's okay. You can talk about anything here. Why do you and your mom argue?
She's always telling me what to do. She doesn't like my boyfriends at all.
Doesn't like what boyfriends? Remember, you're 5 years old, Sarah.
Not her mom. My mom.
Whose mom are we talking about?
I told you. Mine. And before.
And who are you?
Penny.
Penny who?
Penny Romig.
Why are you here, Penny?
Because of the things that happened. With him.
With who? What happened?
I was so afraid that he would be angry.
About what? Why would he be mad?
The things that I said. But he said that we needed to talk about it. There's this place where we could go and we could be alone. He took me there. His car.
Where did he take you?
I don't know. A big smelly place.
What time is it?
It's 3:20 in the morning. He's coming towards me. He's got something sharp in his hand. What? He's gonna hurt me. What is?
It's okay. You're safe.
He wants to hurt me. Why does? Cut me. Why would he cut me?
Listen to me, Sarah. When I snap my fingers, you'll wake up.
He's hurting me. Bring her out of it.
Wake up. Wake up, Sarah.
He killed her. Tell you something else.
Okay.
He didn't do it.
What?
He didn't kill that woman.
Honey, the police say this man killed her. And your father.
He didn't do it.
How do you know? Hi, Matt.
Kim,
good to see you.
You do. So, what's going on? What are you doing around here?
Well, I was just hoping. Do you have a few minutes?
For you? Yeah, of course. This way.
So, it's been a while, huh?
Yeah, almost 6 years.
Jeez, I'm sorry, Kim. I keep meaning to call. Something comes up.
Same here.
Hey, did you hear I got married?
No way. Congratulations.
Then you probably didn't hear I got divorced, too.
Oh, what happened?
You know how it is. You fall off the wagon 7-8 times, a woman starts to have second thoughts. Go figure.
I'm sorry.
What are you gonna do, huh? Grab the stuff for you. That was a good day.
Yeah.
A lot of good days. Of course, was the best partner a guy could have. So, how's Sarah? She's got to be, what, about 10 years old now?
Actually, she's the reason why I'm here.
What is it? What's wrong?
I'm really scared for her, Matt. She's been seeing things.
What do you mean?
Well, she's been having these visions, and believe me, I know this is going to sound crazy. But sometimes she thinks she's Penny Romig.
Romig? That's the girl Chris and I caught her kiss.
Sarah's convinced that Ben Davies didn't kill her or Chris, and that the real killer's still out there.
Kim, you know that's just not possible, right?
Well, that's what I thought, but... But then there's been these things, and... Matt, I'm just not so sure.
You're not so sure about what? I mean, ballistics, forensics, Davies was the guy. The case is closed.
Can I see the file?
Oh, are you sure that's a good idea? For you, I mean.
Look on the back.
She's good, huh?
I have a stack of those. She's been drawing this woman her whole life. The same woman. It's Penny Romig.
Oh, come on, Kim.
It's her. Matt, tell me how a five-year-old can draw someone that she knows nothing about.
I don't know. She saw her on television, maybe in a newspaper. I don't know.
No, I've kept her from this. I didn't want her to know until she was old enough to understand. She didn't even know Penny Romig's name until a few days ago.
Kim, I'm a cop. I deal with facts, evidence, black, white, this kind of stuff. It's way over my head.
Tell me about it. Sarah was speaking French in her sleep a few nights ago. Never studied French a day in her life. Please, Matt, show me the records.
All right. Okay, that's strange. It's listed as a cold case.
Well, what's the difference?
Closed is closed. Solved. Right? Cold case is left open, basically put on the back burner until new evidence comes along.
Well, maybe it was a clerical mistake.
Yeah, maybe. But the problem is, I can't open a cold case file without the captain's okay, and something tells me Sarah's visions aren't going to be enough to convince him.
So what do I do?
You know what? Check with the coroner's office. They keep their own records on homicides, okay?
Thanks, Matt.
You, believe her?
She believes it. In one way or another, I want to make this okay for her.
Mrs. Shea, what a pleasant surprise.
Captain Murphy.
How have you been?
Fine, thank you.
What brings you back to this jungle?
Well, I was just in the neighborhood and I thought I'd stop by and say hello to Detective Carson.
Well, that was nice of you. Just stop by one day and we'll have lunch.
I'll do that.
You take care. Saw Mrs. Shea on her way out.
Yeah, she wanted to talk.
Really? After all these years?
Her daughter's having some problems.
Nothing serious, I hope.
I should be okay.
Good. After what happened to her father, I'd say that family's had enough problems. Wouldn't you?
Name of deceased?
Penny Romig.
It's not releasing the document. It's been flagged restricted. Well, you'll need a court order to get it released.
After 10 years?
Well, I'm just telling you what it says.
Isn't there anything else you can do?
Ron, don't really in the investigation. I can't comment on the specifics of the case.
Who's that?
Yeah, that's Dr. Robert Marquette, County Coroner. All right, as soon as I finish my report. Okay, you too.
Excuse me, Dr. Marquette? I was hoping that maybe you could help me.
Well, what can I do for you?
Well, I'm trying to get a copy of an autopsy report, and for some reason it's been marked restricted. It's 10 years old, and... Well, is that normal?
Not at all.
It's probably a mistake, but I don't have the authorization to access it.
Look, I have another meeting, and... Let me see what I can do. Please. Name of deceased?
Penny Romig.
Romig, homicide victim, multiple stab wounds. They found her in a park. Is that right?
Yes.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to sound insensitive. A test I like to give myself, see if I can remember their names, their COD, cause of death. Are we a friend or family?
More of a friend of a friend.
Well, I'm not having any luck either. That doesn't make sense. Yeah, it was awful what that creep did to her. What was his name? Davies.
Yes.
And there was a police detective investigating the murder. Davies shot him.
Detective Chris Shea.
Shea, yes. Yeah, he died too. Yeah, but not before he gave that animal what he deserved.
He was my husband.
Oh, I'm sorry, Mrs. Shea. Your husband was a brave man. A man of disrespect. I'm sorry. I'm already late for my meeting. Why don't you give your number to Leon, and I'll see what I can do.
Thank you.
I'm on my way.
Billions of people around the world believe in reincarnation, but I suppose they're all wrong too?
I don't know. I'm just... Okay, something's going on. I'll give you that.
She knew exactly where Penny's old apartment was. That's more than something. She was experiencing her past life as Penny.
Okay, fine. Suppose you're right. Just suppose.
Why Sarah? Usually there's some kind of connection. It isn't just random. Penny Roma came back as Sarah for a reason. When the time is right, you'll find out why.
I just want my little girl back.
Thought you were at the police station.
Excuse me?
With your daughter?
What are you talking about?
A Detective Carson called, said there was an emergency, that you were already there. They were sending a car for Sarah.
Where's Sarah?
She left about 5 minutes ago.
Lock down the school.
I'll page the principal.
No, just do it. Hurry.
Sir Shay, did you come by here?
No.
Get back to the class. It's not safe for you here.
Honey, I know.
I just heard. Is Sarah okay?
No, she's not okay. Somebody just tried to kidnap her.
All right, take a breath. Calm down.
I don't want to calm down.
Easy. I'm on your side, remember?
Are you sure about that?
What the hell is that supposed to mean?
They said you called the school, Matt. Said to have Sarah released from class and that somebody would pick her up.
Wait a minute.
There was a car waiting for her. I got there just in time.
You think I would do that?
What am I supposed to think, huh? What would you think?
All right, Kim, listen to me, okay? I'm gonna take care of this. Get on the phone, get me the records. Every call into school the last 2 hours. Go. All right, what kind of car was it?
A black sedan. Four doors, I think.
You see the driver?
It had, tinted windows.
Okay, what about a license plate?
It happened too fast.
All right, never mind. We can do this later. Take Sarah home. I'll give you a call in a couple of hours. Chris was like a brother to me. You know I'd never do anything to hurt you or Sarah, right?
Who is it?
Kim, it's me, Matt.
Matt.
Should've called first. But, we checked out that call to the school. It came from a payphone a few blocks over. Could've been anyone.
They used your name, Matt. Why would they do that if they didn't know I'd come to see you?
We don't know it's a cop, Kim.
We don't know it's not.
Look, just because Sarah has a couple dreams, you want to open this can of worms, you're trying to make her feel better.
You don't get it, Matt. I didn't ask for this. I spent the last 10 years trying to move on, make a life for Sarah and me. Why in God's name would I put myself through this again?
Then don't. Stop now. Just let him rest.
No. Somebody tried to take my daughter. And I don't think it's a coincidence. And if I don't find the truth, I will always be looking over my shoulder.
Well, you don't have to do it alone.
Sarah, go back to sleep. Pam's gonna stay with you for a couple hours until I get home. I love you too. I hope Sarah will be okay with Pam. It was pretty scary for her today. Okay, you wanna tell me where we are?
That is where they keep the cold case records. By this time of night, there's probably only one guard on.
Wait a minute, you're not planning on stealing these records, are you?
You got any better ideas?
Matt, are you sure you want to take this risk? Okay. Okay, just tell me what you want me to do.
I want you to keep an eye out. Let me know if anybody else shows up.
Hey, hold on a second. How are you gonna get in?
Well, that is what makes all this so exciting, isn't it?
Sitting there. Wait.
What? I can't hear you.
He's leaving.
It was the same car you saw at the school?
Maybe. I don't know. It's gone.
All right, look, just sit tight. I'm almost through, okay?
Yeah.
only looking for some change.
Wait. Can you act crazy?
That's what I do. You get away! You leave that lady alone! Freak! Get out of here! Yes! Leave that lady alone! Get out of here!
Go. You know, it says Penny Romig's blood alcohol level was 0.18. That's twice the legal limit.
That's probably how Davy's got a jump on her. She's pretty hammered that night.
Her car wasn't found at the park, and there was no way she could drive in that condition anyway. But it also says her prints weren't in Davy's car either. So how'd she get there?
She was dead almost 48 hours before they found her. That's plenty of time for him to wipe down his vehicle.
But the knife was still under his seat. He'd wipe down the car, but he'd leave the murder weapon?
Maybe he forgot. I don't know. Kim, your average psycho is not that bright. You have anything at all to drink in this house?
There's scotch in the cabinet.
You want one?
No.
I know that look.
Something else that doesn't make sense to me. If this was yours and Chris's case, how come Captain Murphy's signature is all over this?
I'm gonna tell you something. And you're not gonna like it. I'll tell you anyway. Because it's time, you know.
Knew what?
Murphy's name is all over that file, because that's how he takes care of business. Anything he doesn't want to go public, he throws in a few convenient loose ends, labels it a cold case, never sees the light of day.
Oh, wait a minute. Are you saying that Murphy did something with this case?
Chris, he had a way about him, a look he'd get. You could tell when he was closing in and he was getting that look with the Romig case. The problem was, he kept me locked out, which wasn't like him. I asked him. He said it was for my own protection.
Protection from who?
He wouldn't say, but he got a tip that night that Davies wanted to meet, wanted to talk about who killed the girl. Davies was supposed to be a witness, not a suspect.
Wait, he got a tip? Davies didn't call?
To this day, I don't know who called Chris, but whoever it was said that Davies wanted to talk to him alone. So we went down there, and Chris jumps out of the car. He tells me to wait. A couple minutes, I hear two shots, back to back. And I hear two more.
What happened, Matt?
Ran into the alley. Davis is already dead. And I found Chris, who's lying in a pile of trash. He was looking at me. Like he wanted to tell me something.
Matt, you said Chris was dead when you got there.
I lied to you, Kim. I lied to everybody.
How could you do that?
Because it wasn't his weapon.
What?
I knew Chris's weapon like it was my own, and the one in his hand wasn't it. It wasn't Chris's gun.
But if you were so sure that that wasn't Chris's gun, why didn't you tell anybody?
You don't think I tried? Murphy shows up, and he takes over the scene. I tell him this is the wrong gun. He gives me this look, and he says I'm distraught. And I tell him how Davies had wanted to meet, how the whole thing was starting to smell like a setup.
What did he say?
He asked me how I thought I would smell if everyone found out I had booze on my breath that night. And with my reputation on the wagon, off the wagon, I got out. I might as well kiss my career goodbye.
You let him threaten you? With Chris lying there, you ignored the truth?
The truth was, I had a couple of drinks.
Like a brother, you said!
I was scared, all right? I was scared! I could feel it. Murphy had to be mixed up in this. Somehow. Maybe he even took Chris out himself. I don't know, but if he could get to Chris, I knew he could sure as hell get to me a whole lot quicker.
So Sarah was right.
Davies didn't kill that girl.
Whoever killed Chris and that girl, it's too late. There's nothing we can do about it now.
Unless you have a witness.
What are you talking about, sweetie?
Well, I was there.
You're not Kim.
She sees things, Matt. She knows about Penny's death.
I am not going to let this happen. You're not going to chase this particular wild goose. It's too dangerous.
It was at Sally's bar. That's where Penny worked. And that's where he picked her up that night.
With or without you, Matt?
Yeah, honey, the sign's here, just like you drew it.
You go past a bar. There's a table in the back somewhere with a lamp that has a horse on it.
Just past the bar, there's a table with a horse lamp on it. Okay, baby. I'll call you back. Let's go.
Whoa, hold on.
What's he doing here?
Used to be a cop bar. Some of the old timers still hang out now and then.
Are you inside?
Yeah, I'm in.
What about the bartender? Jimmy, is he limping?
Yeah, I see him. He's limping.
She waited for him there, and he called her from the car to come out.
Who called?
I don't know his name.
What can I get for you folks?
Jimmy.
Mom?
Hi, good to see you.
Have we met?
Yeah, a long time ago. My sister used to work here. Penny Romig?
I remember Penny. Sweet kid. Shame what happened to her.
Yeah, it's 10 years ago this week.
Time flies, I guess, huh?
Were you here that night?
You reopening the case, detective?
No, actually, it's me. You know, after all this time, I still need closure.
She wasn't working that night, though. She came in. Supposed to meet some guy she'd been seeing. Seemed pretty upset.
Why?
Wouldn't say. Anyway, the guy calls and says, put on the phone.
You recognize the voice?
Must have been Benny, right? That's what it says in all the papers.
You knew Davies?
Yeah, he'd come in, he'd shoot the breeze. I tell you, I think maybe he had a thing for Penny. She was very friendly, though.
Did you see him that night?
No, he said he'd wait for her in the car, told her to come out. I offered to walk her. She said she'd be okay. That's the last time I saw her.
Was she drinking? Do you remember?
Funny thing about that. I hadn't seen her take a drink in a couple of weeks. She started drinking milk.
Milk?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I thought maybe she was saving her money or something. Well, she learned how to speak French pretty good. Said she was going to some fancy art school there.
Well, thanks for talking to us.
No problem. For what it's worth, your sister was good people.
Blood alcohol be so high as she hadn't been drinking.
You're assuming that he's telling the truth.
He has no reason to lie.
A guy like that lying's a reflex.
He cared about her. I could feel it.
What are you getting all ooh on me now too, or what?
I'm serious, Matt.
Hang on. Carson. Yeah? Yeah, okay. What now? Yeah, no, that's fine. All right.
Who's that?
Murphy. He wants me to come by the station.
Now? What for?
Said he would tell me when I get there.
What a coincidence.
Yeah, no such thing.
Call me later.
Yeah, sure.
Hello?
You wanted to talk to me?
I still get chills. My people out there, giving everything for this city, risking their lives. Nothing like it. That kind of dedication and loyalty, that's what keeps me going, especially the loyalty.
Said there was a problem.
You've been out there a long time. You know how it works. We've got to be able to trust each other. You and me, everybody in here. Otherwise, you never know what might happen.
Yeah.
That's why it breaks my heart to tell you this, Detective. I don't trust you, Matt.
Yeah, I don't follow.
You think I wouldn't find out? I have eyes everywhere, Carson. Places you don't know. Breaking into a restricted area, tampering with evidence.
I don't know what you're talking about.
What do you think you're doing here, Detective? Are you being somebody's hero? Because you're lining up on the wrong side and people are going to get hurt. Is that what you want? Now, why don't you just tell me what you got yourself into? And we'll sort it out.
Can't help you, Captain.
Have it your way. You're on suspension as of right now, gun and badge. You know, when Internal Affairs opens the book on you, they're gonna go all the way back, including the night you were more worried about getting your next drink than looking after your partner.
We're done there.
Oh, yeah. I'd say you're done.
It's pretty here.
Yeah, it's very nice.
You don't like to come here?
Oh, no, Sarah, I do like to come here. It helps me remember so many things. But sometimes remembering's hard. When I remember your daddy, it just reminds me how much I miss him.
And that makes me sad.
When you love someone and they're not with you anymore, it makes you sad, yeah.
I'm sorry he's not here.
You too, baby.
I think Daddy would want us to know.
Know what?
Know what really happened to him.
Come on, honey, don't stare. Sarah.
You come here a lot.
Nearly every day.
You don't have to feel so sad.
Sarah, let's go back to the car. You don't want to bother people. Oh, my God.
Did you know our daughter?
Yes.
But how old are you?
No, she means that I knew her. I've talked about her so much.
She used to get mad at you sometimes. For not trusting her, for not believing that she could be an artist. But even when she was angry, she knew that you loved her. You just wanted her to be happy.
Sarah.
She's sorry she said she hated you. She didn't mean it. She loved you very much.
Thank you.
Go back to that apartment.
What? No, that's out of the question.
I told you there's something in there. We have to find it.
I'm not taking you back there. It's too dangerous. Now that's final.
You could go. I know where there's a key. You wouldn't have to break in or anything. Has he come out yet?
Not yet. I'll let you know when I see him, okay? Wait. There he is. He's leaving.
Be careful, okay?
All clear.
Is there a fire extinguisher?
Yes.
Just reach up. It's taped underneath.
Pretty slick.
She forgot her keys all the time. Can you show me? She used to sit by that window and draw. It was her quiet spot.
All right, kiddo, what am I looking for?
I don't know. Can you show me the other way? There's so much garbage. It didn't look like this before.
Baby, this isn't working. You know, I better get out of here.
No, Mom, wait. I don't know. A black hole or something.
A black hole, Sarah, that doesn't make...
Mom?
Wait.
That's it. That's where it is.
Sarah, are you sure?
Yes.
Oh!
Mom? Mom!
I'm okay. I'm okay.
Mom!
Sarah, wait. I think I found something.
What? What is it?
Hold on.
What does it say?
Wait a sec. Home pregnancy test.
She was pregnant.
But why would she hide this?
wrote this 2 days before she was murdered. That's why she wanted to talk to him. She was pregnant.
I don't understand.
It's okay. Sarah, I'm leaving now. I can explain.
I caught you here before. I told you to stay the hell away.
Mom, did he come back?
Look, I'm not here to rob you. I'm just looking for some things that the girl who used to live here before might have left.
Well, that don't give you the right to come into somebody's place.
No, you're right. And I'm sorry, and I'm not gonna bother you anymore. I'm just gonna leave.
I heard once. Somebody breaks in, well, you got the right to do anything you want. To defend your property.
I'm calling the police.
No, I'm gonna walk out now.
Oh, I don't think so. Now, I think what I'm gonna have to do is search you. See that you ain't stolen nothing. I'm gonna have to search you a long time.
I'm calling them right now.
Sir, do you have the address?
Son of a bitch! Who is that? Who's listening to us?
She was pregnant when she was murdered, and it's not in the autopsy report. Why would that be?
Well, I spoke to Marquette the other day, the coroner. He seemed pretty surprised that he couldn't access Penny's autopsy. Now, if we could prove that somebody tampered with his records, he might be able to help us.
It's a start.
We'll go in the morning.
You better do it. I have been suspended.
Why?
Murphy found out I went into the cold case vault, and he's threatening to take it to internal affairs.
I'm sorry, Matt. This is all my fault.
Don't you believe it? I got myself into this a long time ago. What you did, you and Sarah both, you gave me the chance to get myself out of it.
You want a drink?
I'm good. And you better watch yourself. Murphy's probably already figured out you're involved. He's gonna want to know where all this is headed.
I understand.
I want to know where you're at all times. And no more breaking into people's houses either.
Sorry.
You gotta take care of yourself. Got that little girl upstairs. So, where do I sleep?
Excuse me?
Well, I'm camping out here until further notice. Keep an eye on you two. Unless you got a problem with that.
No. The couch is all yours.
Couch is good.
I'm sorry I haven't gotten back to you, Mrs. Shea. The truth is, I'm still shut out of my own system. I can't access a copy of Penny Romig's autopsy report.
I actually dug up a copy myself. And that's why I'm here. I have a few questions.
I'm impressed. How did you manage that?
I'd rather not say, if you don't mind.
I see. Do you have it with you?
Yes. What I was wondering is, I found out that Penny Romig was pregnant, but it doesn't mention it here in the report.
Well, I never would have left out something that important.
And it also says that her blood alcohol level was 0.18. Now, the bartender where she works said she hadn't had a drink in weeks.
Well, that doesn't make sense.
That's what I mean. I just don't understand.
If you repeat this, I'll deny we ever had this conversation. This isn't the first report of mine that's been altered. For a long time, I suspected that someone is using their work for the city to cover up their crimes.
Well, then you could help me. If you just tell me what you know and which report that...
Mrs. Shea, You may think you know what you're getting into, but you really have no idea. And given my circumstances, I really can't help you. I'm sorry, but you're on your own. And if you wouldn't mind some advice, burn those papers. And don't speak of this to anyone ever again.
If you wake your daughter, my partner in her room will kill her. You understand?
What do you want?
And what will you got from the cold case warehouse? You don't want to do that, Mrs. Shay.
It's in the downstairs closet.
Hi. The doctor said the knife missed any vital organs, but you've lost a lot of blood. You have to rest.
Sarah?
She's okay. Thank you. I need to look at your drawings.
Are you gonna keep looking?
This is where they found Penny.
She was over there in the trees.
This isn't the place.
What do you mean?
The place I saw it. It was big. And inside.
This place, honey? I'm sorry. You shouldn't have to do this. I just don't know any other way.
He took her to this place. With no windows. But there were shells and pointy things. And she wanted to talk to him about the baby. Because she wanted to keep it. He tried to change her mind, but she wouldn't. He started to argue and... then he just... stops talking. Touches her face. But that's so she won't see the knife. She tries to stop him, but it's too late. And he kills her.
We have to find this place.
How?
Start where she started. That night.
I think that she came back so that what happened to her won't happen to anybody else. And because, to make you feel better, I mean, you miss Daddy so much.
I do miss him, honey. What is it, baby? What do you see?
Go that way. Turn left up here.
Wait in the car and lock the doors.
What? No, I have to come with
you. Sarah, just once. They store out here.
Mrs. Shea.
Dr. Marquette, I wasn't expecting to see you here.
Well, I could say the same thing. What brings you all the way out here?
Oh, it's a bit complicated. I was hoping to find out when I got here. Do you know what's stored in this building?
Well, believe it or not, the coroner's office used to use it when there was a storm or a fire or some sort of natural disaster. Well, that was years ago, before my time, of course. Well, it sounds a bit macabre to me.
No kidding.
City wants to demolish the place. I'm supposed to be meeting someone here to see about cleaning it out. Looks like I haven't stood up.
Well, I've got to be going anyway. I've got my daughter in the car.
Killed Penny.
You mean Marquette?
Yes.
I want to come with you.
You can't, baby. It's too dangerous.
Well, then call the police.
And tell them what? My daughter's a reincarnation of another woman?
I'm sorry.
Look, the police are mixed up in this. I don't even know if I can trust them. Matt's right. We need proof, real proof, that he killed Penny.
He killed Daddy, too.
I think so. That's why we have to do this right. So he doesn't get away with it. Okay? Come on in, sweetheart.
You come back, okay?
I should have taken care of them when he had the chance.
That was never the deal.
Well, we're changing the deal.
The kid, too?
It's a bit late in the game to develop a conscience.
And when the cop's friends come knocking?
This cop's got no friends. But don't worry. I'll take care of the police. You just do your job. You find her, you follow her, and you kill her.
Hello, Mrs. Shea.
Murphy, I need to speak to you, alone. What the hell? You had better start talking, and fast. What happened?
At a 911, this location call was disconnected. Sent a unit to check it out. Found her cell phone over in the corner there, and your pit bull hoisted on his own petard. Funny old world, isn't it?
You haven't seen my office yet.
What do you mean?
She found the original autopsy reports.
You kept them?
Just a little insurance in case anyone got cold feet.
You dumb son of a bitch.
You have to find her and kill her.
Oh, no, Marquette. You and I, we're done.
Walk away now, I swear I'll ruin you.
And how is that?
One of those reports was for her husband. If I go down, you go with me. Evidence tampering, conspiracy to murder. And that's just for starters. You will do as I say, Captain. You don't have a choice.
If anything happens, you'll know what to do.
Could you?
Where's Sarah?
Do you have any idea of the mess that you have made for me?
Where is she?
You know, I was a good cop once. But I made a serious mistake. I could have been charged in the death of a scumbag drug dealer, or at the very least, kicked off the force. Marquette changed the autopsy report, though. And he made me look like a hero instead. Only he's never let me forget that I owe him, and he's never gonna.
But why kill Penny? Why Chris?
Because she wouldn't go away quietly like the others. She wanted to have his baby. So he called me and said, oh, there's been an accident. She's dead. And then he decided, I guess that was too neat, so he cut her up, made it look like a psycho did it. Only Chris wasn't buying it.
So you set up Ben Davies?
Marquette told me find somebody who wouldn't be missed. I picked Davies.
Marquette was the one that called Chris that night. Told him where to meet Davies.
I found out later Davies was already dead. Marquette had taken care of him, and then he waited to ambush Chris. And when I got there, I could see that Chris's gun had been swapped. So I knew what had happened.
You should have done something.
It was already done. I couldn't change it, so I decided to keep my mouth shut.
You could have told the truth!
There was nothing that I could do!
Then do something now, Murphy. Make it right.
You read my mind.
Then tell me where my daughter is.
Marquette took her to the old coroner's warehouse. He told me that I don't have a choice. He was wrong.
Murphy, no! Call the police. Tell them everything that happened.
What about you?
I'm gonna go get Sarah.
Daughter's visions, Mrs. Shea.
Sarah?
How she sees, what Penny saw. Her descriptions are quite chilling. And so exact.
I should know. I was there.
Let her go.
As soon as you get me those reports you took from my office.
I don't have them with me.
Excuse me?
I can take you to them.
Do I really look stupid to you, Mrs. Shea? Go get them and bring them to me.
I won't leave her.
You don't have a choice.
Sarah? You killed our baby! They won't let you kill again!
Oh my God.
Let me go! You let me go, Robert!
It's not possible.
Let me go! They won't let you get out of this! Baby!
Why are you...
I'm sorry!
Next time, wake me up.
I hope he doesn't mind I brought Penny's favorites.
I'm sure he'll love them too, honey. No more bad dreams?
No more bad dreams.